beauties, thank you for watching and happy holidays. I created this fun tutorial inspired by one of my favorite movies, The Nightmare Before Christmas. When I was younger, I was really intrigued by movies that featured characters that looked like cartoons but had a three-dimensional effect. They're referred to as stop-motion animation, so basically the characters can move just like real people. Although I loved this movie as a child, I'm older now, I'm 21, and I still really love this movie. The door scene in the beginning of the film really stuck with me visually, and it's something that I really never forgot. I also really love that this is one of the very few dark fantasy style movies that are appropriate for kids, which I think is really unique. I also wanted to mention that this movie was originally a poem written by Tim Burton that later turned into a film, which I thought was really cool. Some of you may know this movie is based around Jack Skellington. He's the pumpkin king of Halloween Town. He's tired of the same old thing every year, so he wanders into the woods. He finds some holiday trees, and each tree has a town in it. So he goes into the Christmas one, and he finds himself in Christmas Town. My favorite character from this movie is actually Sally. She's a stitched-together humanoid ragdoll. She has some premonitions of Jack's plan, and if you've watched this movie, you know how clever and smart she is. She also has a really big crush on Jack, and they end up together in the end on Pumpkin Hill. For Halloween this year, I did Emily from The Corpse Bride. This is also another Tim Burton movie, so if you'd like to see that, click my link in the description box and check that out. I'll have it linked for you guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to like it, subscribe, share, and don't forget to turn on my notifications so you don't miss a thing from me. And if you would like to learn how to transform into Sally from The Nightmare Before Christmas, then please continue on watching. To create the blue base, I went in with a water-activated paint, and this is a light blue shade. It dries a little bit darker, and you're going to want to cover your whole entire face with this, so even your eyelids, and you really want to go over until you have a very even base. I also started to bring this down my neck and onto my chest. So next I went in with a dark blue water activated paint, and I decided to apply this to my eyebrows, but because she really doesn't have eyebrows, I layered this on and dampened a sponge and kind of pressed into this to give the illusion of a bone, and I'm gonna go in and shade this later, but I really didn't want to add any brows to her very much. She does have very round eyes, so I went into a black shadow and I created a very round cut crease. Because my eyes are somewhat hooded and when I look straight into the camera, you can't really see the crease, I had to go up very high, so I definitely exaggerated this just for the look of the character, and I layered in that black until I had a very pronounced crease. I went in with two blue shades, one was a little bit lighter and one was a dark blue, and I just layered this on top of the black and shaded it up so it created a nice gradient effect and kind of layered down into the black. It kind of blends into her skin color, and I wanted this to be a very natural cut crease. It's very similar to what she has. It's just a lot of definition. So I next went in and layered this light blue that matches the body paint onto the lid, and I just pressed this right into my lid, and this blends right into the skin color we created. I went into this dark blue again, and I decided to create something that I've seen in a lot of Korean makeup and a lot of anime makeup. I wanted to make these eyes very big, so I layered this straight out, basically in a straight line, and I went in with a NYX Jumbo Pencil in Milk. And this pencil is amazing for these type of looks, these character looks. It's great. And for a liner, I wanted to use a body paint, so I used a black water-activated paint and created a very small wing. It's very minimal. She did have a pretty dark line on her lash line, so I definitely had to add that. I also went in with a bright highlight for the inner corner, just a very shimmery white to open up the eyes, and next I went in and stacked some lashes together. These lashes are very spiky, and if you notice, the character does have very spiky, long lashes. I didn't want to draw them on just for the sake of the look. I really didn't want it to look messy or sloppy, so I stuck with lashes only. You can layer as many as you want, but I did layer two, and I felt like they did give a very similar look, although they weren't as exaggerated. I do think it's very similar if you stack lashes. I went into a dark blue shadow and started kind of patching this around my face. The character herself has very patchy type of skin, so I did the same effect. I went into a white face powder and just highlighted all around the face, which I think is very important, and I wouldn't skip this step if I were you. The white highlight just makes everything come together, so you could use like a matte white eyeshadow or anything like that. And now I started to create the stitches on the face. Now, I do not have a steady hand, so I had to go back in and kind of correct this a couple times. sometimes, but you really don't have to be a pro to know how to do these stitches. I went over with a white, and I really wanted these stitches to be kind of like a 3D effect, so I went back in with a black shadow, and I shaded right underneath them. Although she does have black stitches, this looks much better than just applying a black body paint if you create the 3D stitches. So next I went into the mouth area and I did create her little mouth stitches the same exact way I did to her face. And I'm also going to repeat this step to my body as well. I did do my whole body, so if you're going out for Halloween, I would suggest doing that. I know you can buy leggings and stuff at the store, but I think painting your whole body really gives an awesome, realistic look. So next I went in with a red liquid lipstick, and I wanted to do a very dark red similar to her color. She had a very dark red. It's not blue red, it's very dark, it's almost like a burgundy color. And I just layered this onto my lips and I created a very round shape, kind of like a doll. She is very doll-like, she's a rag doll, so I wanted to make this as dolly as I possibly could. And I rounded out the lips in the Cupid's bow area. So next I went in with a dark blue shadow again, and I wanted to layer this underneath the brow to create the look of a bone. I didn't want to block out my brows for this look, I just wanted to keep my natural brows and just create that look. I also used this to contour my nose as well as my face, and I just kept adding where I needed to pretty much for this entire look. I went in with some mascara just to add some spikiness to the lashes. I normally wouldn't do this with a normal beauty look, but for this look, I think it's appropriate to add mascara just right to the tips of the lashes. I next went in with the light blue body paint and I started to create the stitches on my body. So she does have a black stitch around her neck. I did make them pretty gawky and big because I wanted them to be very visible, but you can go as thin or as thick as you want. I think with the Tim Burton style looks I see in the movies, everything's pretty gawky, so I went pretty big when it came to the stitches. I just did them the same way I did my face, and I went back in with the black shadow to shade them and make them look 3D. I really think this adds so much to the look, so I would not skip the shading at all. I next went back in with that dark blue I've been using pretty much everywhere, and I shaded around my bones. I pretty much sucked my body in until I could feel kind of like a crevice, and I just went into that crevice with the shade and kind of packed it right in. I'm next working on my arm, and I'll show you guys a little bit how to do this. It's the same exact thing I did with my face. I would definitely recommend taking your time and having as steady of a hand as possible. It is really hard to do your opposite side. I did notice that, but if you take your time, it's very easy, and I would just say, if you have enough time, this look is not that hard, so you just have to have a lot of time to do it. So I went in again with the dark blue shadow that I was using on my face, and I decided to shade around the stitches just to create some patchiness because the character herself is very patchy and she has a little bit of shading going on. I popped in some white contacts, and now for the wig, which I think really completes the look. She does have red hair. It's kind of like a rag doll's hair, you could say, but I went with something a little bit more realistic just to kind of change up the look. I don't always like to go with the exact look of the character, just to kind of put my own twist on it. I painted my ears, and that was pretty much it for this look. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It was so much fun for me. Happy holidays. Don't forget to subscribe, turn my notifications on, like this video, and share with any friends who love The Nightmare Before Christmas. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you all in my next tutorial.